Hi! Me and my family have spent the last 2 months traveling around Australia. Our youngest is 1 year and our oldest is 4. And we thought we would share some of our experience in terms of how it's been like traveling with the Nordic Cab Explorer. And this won't be a full review, it's more like what we think. So there are bits and pieces that we probably won't cover, but yeah, you can see it on some other YouTube clips and so on. But we'll see. We can start with that we're really pleased with the way things turned out in terms of traveling with the Noridc Cab. The first impression, once you see it, is that it's huge. It's really, really, really big. Especially when you're used to just pushing around a single pram, then this is quite big. But it grows on you quite fast. But it takes a little bit time to get used to, especially in crowded areas. And the reason for why we chose the Explorer is that it has some pretty basic functionality. It's not very complex, but yet it can replace a regular pram if you would like that. And that was a really important thing for us, because our 1 year old needs to get his beauty sleep at least once a day, preferably 2 times a day. And we also need to be able to move about with our oldest, and she could sit next to our youngest son when he is sleeping. So that was a very big thing for us, because we wanted to be able to go anywhere and not be limited to sleeping hours, because that wouldn't really work. So it turns out very well, and he slept really good, even though our daughter sat next to him. So very pleased with that. There were a few things that we were a little bit anxious about. One, the sheer size of it. How easy will it be to move about? Because we were doing a kind of a backpacking tour, and we were going to use all sorts of transport. So we ended up traveling by plane, train, boat, car, camper van, taxi, tram, bike, and of course we walked quite a lot. So we're a bit concerned about how that would work, but we had almost no issues. So with a bit of planning, it turns out quite well. Another thing is the heat. Of course, this is you have a cab and a roof. And we were a bit anxious about it might getting a little bit too hot inside. And for that reason, we, on the back here, we just added a easy strap in the back here, which we just added a thermometer that showed the inside and outside temperature. It never showed more than about 2 degrees Celsius difference between inside and outside, so it was really pleased, but it was nice to ease our mind on hot days. We also added a small strap, well, as I said, we added a strap so we can attach our backpacks, so it just clips the backpacks, so we didn't have to carry anything. And that turned out also quite nice. And another change that we did, that we soon discovered, while we were testing prior to leaving was because of the seating arrangement in the Nordic Cab. You have the option of having a split seat, so you can adjust, we can lay one of the seats completely flat and the other one can be in a raised position. And that works well. Only downside is that the cushion, the seat, is just a single piece. So in order for you to be able to lay one of the seats flat, you need to push the whole seating arrangement all the way in the front. And our four-year-old won't be able to have any leg room. So the legs will typically stick outside the compartment. So, and that's really not very comfortable when you're going to sit inside for a very long time. So I come up with a very simple solution that worked brilliant, if I may say. And what I did is that I took a piece of steel and just cut it in this size and use some elbow grease to just bend it. Also made two small holes which so we can fasten this on the original bolts for the small front wheel. So this actually just sits like this. And then you can have the legs sticking out really comfortably. This is not something that you can use when you're riding a bike, because the legs, well, there might be a slight chance of the legs getting stuck in the rear wheel of the bike. So we only used that when we were walking. But then again, it turned out quite well. Because then we could, another good thing about this is that we got the most amount of luggage space that we could have. And we typically packed two backpacks and two large plastic bags and a bag of food. And we all had that inside and on the pram. So really pleased with the luggage capacity of it. And it's also a lot of room to toys and shovels and buckets and all really important stuff. Another thing that we also did was that we replaced the original back tires with some Big Apple tires. We got those from Nordic Cab as well. It's an optional extra, but this is something you definitely want to replace, because this increases the ride comfort hugely. So this was a very, very good decision. You can also, as long as you bring a pump, which you should, you can also adjust the air pressure according to the ground that you're traveling on. So for instance, when you're walking at the beach, you would let a lot of air out, so it would be easier to walk on the beach. And on gravel and tarmac, you would vary the pressure a little bit. So really pleased with it. Another benefit is that it's strengthened, so it doesn't puncture that easily. We did actually manage to get a puncture, but that was after going through a bush of thorns, and yeah. That was a little bit messy. And that's about the changes that we did to it. So yeah, it worked good. another thing, we brought both the jogging wheel, because this is really nice when you're out in a little bit more open areas, or out walking in the bush or something, because it gives more stability when you're walking. It also increases the ride comfort a little bit, because you won't get that much of a movement in the pram. But if you're in a urban area, like in going into the shops, going by public transport and such, this won't work very well, because the pram will get too big. So then you need this wheel, and this is really good, because you'll be able to move the pram very easily and maneuver it easily. So we typically brought both the small wheel and the large wheel with these, and you can get everything inside, so you don't have to carry anything, or yeah, so it's more than enough room for it. This doesn't provide any dampening, so the ride comfort will be a little bit bumpy if you're going on a gravel road, but in the city it's good. The only time where it would be preferably to have two small front wheels is if you have to, if you have a step, if you're going into the bus and you have a step, so you need to push the pram down and push it in, then it was a little bit more tricky with just one front wheel, but that was the only time. And one wheel, less to drag about. So yeah, really don't miss having two. And if you take a look at the features that we have, it has quite good sun protection. There are some areas that could have been improved a little bit. And one thing is the side screen. Well, it's easy to operate, but it doesn't go all the way down. So in the early mornings and late afternoons, the sun will actually go through here. And if the child is laying and sleeping, he will actually get the sun in the eyes. So this was a little bit annoying. You also have a pretty good sun protection in front, just tucked away here. So it's fastened with Velcro underneath, like so. This turned out to be a very simple and easy solution as well. The only thing is that it doesn't cover the legs, so you need to have a thin blanket with you, so the legs won't get sunburned. And you also have this this window, which is also very nice to get the bad weather, keep the bad weather outside. You also have a huge mosquito net underneath there as well. And that gives you the ability to get very good air circulation through the cab when it's hot. And that's definitely something you need when you're traveling to a hot area. Another thing that we soon noticed that we improved was that if the children were sleeping and we needed to get inside to fix something or correct something, they woke up, because the bottom here is fastened with Velcro here, and they wake up by the sound. So we just attached the other side of the Velcro here, so it didn't, so it doesn't attach anymore. But we haven't had any reasons for it. We also did the same thing in the back. Did it here. Another thing here is that if you have very long hair and you stick your head inside here, you are going to get stuck by this Velcro here. And you, if you're not very sore, you will probably get free yourself. But my wife needed some help more than once, so yeah, this was also a very easy fix for that. We also have some ventilation here, but we typically didn't use that because it was too hot. So we had the flap open all the time, and then you get a very good circulation through. So really happy with that. One downside, well, another downside to just keep in mind, is that you will get a lot of sun inside the cabin. So we had a thin blanket which we just lay on top here, and that also was a very quick fix for that. You also have a parking brake, worked well, easy to operate, and something to attach to your arm, so if you fall or you slip, the pram won't just shoot ahead. When you are in an urban environment or have a lot of steep downhills, it would be nice with a handbrake. Yeah, but then again, this particular model doesn't have it, but we sometimes missed that. But we have seen various types or solutions for it, but on other models. But it was a little bit too complex, so for this trip we didn't want that. Another thing to bear in mind is that if your child is a little bit on the limit in terms of the length of the Nordic Cab, he will most likely bang his head on this metal bar, which probably won't be the best or most comfortable. So we were a little bit on the limit, but what we found out was that it was a little bit better to just raise the back of the back that he was using a little bit, so he wouldn't bump his head in this. And it, well, for him at least, it gave him a little bit better sleeping position. There's no way that you can do this without having, well, building up a little bit with luggage, but we had a lot of luggage with us, so it worked fine. And it's not a problem when you're biking, because riding a bike, you need to have this, both of the seats raised, so it's not an issue then. And adjusting the seat up and down is also fairly easy. It's just you have a few straps that you're just taking over the metal bar in top and fastening it. So once you've done it a few times, it's very, very easy. And it's also quite fast to pack the whole thing together. You have some zippers on the side, and again Velcro in the bottom and on top, And you also have a fastening mechanism in here, which you just press and collapse everything. And all the wheels and all that comes with it, you will be able to put inside of it. So it takes quite doesn't take up much space. It is a little bit more cumbersome than some other models or types, but once you've done it a few times, yeah, you don't think about it. So I would typically take it out and have it ready by the time the children was out of the car or something. So a little bit of practice and you're all good. Another thing that worked very well is that you have some pretty decent pockets inside. So you will be able to have a lot of toys and most importantly drinking water easily accessible for the kids, and coloring toys, coloring books and everything. So it was very nice for the kids. Another thing that we figured out, well, found out the hard way, is that because of the sheer size, the height and everything, and that the fact that you actually can't see the kids, it's very easy to lose stuff, because if they throw something out, you will not be able to see it and they will just walk by. So we lost a few things that way. So we learned that. So things that you want to have, please don't have it available in front here. And the size inside was, I think, is one of the biggest that you can get. The kids thought it was really spacious. I think you have about 30 centimeter-ish for each one. And the roof height, height is also very good. So it doesn't feel claustrophobic for kids. And the youngest is is still trying to climb in every time he sees it. So he really got used to it. Liked it a lot. You have good windows, good visibility outside for the kids. We also had these headrests, which are very nice when the kids are going to sleep when they're sitting. So these were quite nice. And you can't see it here, but you have 5-point harness. You have a 3-point that is really easy here, and as a belt that goes over the waist. So all in all, we are very pleased. The solutions are easy to handle and operate. It's simple to fix if something goes wrong when you're out in the bush or on the mountain or wherever. And it's not very much that can actually go wrong with it. And it feels like it's very robust built. Another tip is that when you're packing your luggage for the day, you have to think about is it something that we need to have easy access. Then you should pack that in your backpacks, because if one of the children is sleeping, you won't be able to reach anything that you have inside. Another thing is that try to get as much of the heavy stuff you have inside, and don't have that in the backpacks, especially if you're attaching the backpacks in the rear like we did, because you change the whole weight distribution quite a lot. So what could happen is if you take one of the child outside, the whole thing can flip over. So you need to focus a little bit when you're packing. Packing for going on a plane can be very easy, and it can be a little bit bothersome. It depends on the airline, basically. So normally there are no weight limits on prams, on planes. Some airplanes don't see this as a pram. So what they're telling is that it's the normal checking luggage weight that that you have to follow. And then you are very on the edge of some of the, at least the low price airlines. When we had a internal flight in Australia, we actually had to repack the whole luggage because the way we had packed it, it was like 2 kilos too heavy. So it's a big pain. If you just do a little bit, well, take some of the heavy stuff, small pieces in the backpack and so on, we managed to get under the weight limit. But it took at least half an hour extra to fiddle around. So yeah, wasn't very pleased with that. It's not a problem to get under, I think it was 20 kilos. So with all the bits and pieces. Another thing, another improvement that we would like is to get a little bit more accurate handlebar. Because you have a little bit of play in the handlebar, which makes it a little bit more difficult to go down really short steps or something like that. Because once the wheels get over, the wheel will like drop a little bit until the handlebar is in the fixed position again. So that could be a little bit of an improvement. Other than that, very pleased. It gave us the mobility that we wanted and the flexibility, because the kids could sleep in the cab, so we didn't have to be at home for bedtime every time. We tried it, of course, but sometimes you don't catch the right train or you're a little bit delayed. So yeah, we're really pleased with that. And we didn't really have planned the whole trip in details, so we didn't know if what kind of train or how it would move about. We're really pleased that we could easily change between bike and walk, because we could typically we could take the train from one place to another with bicycles, and then bike as far as we could, and then we might have to walk a little bit, and we could do all that stuff without really doing anything. So it's a really handy, practical thing to bring. I've also I've written down some technical details, which comes in a picture afterwards, and we'll also some videos from the trip. So I hope this was a little bit informative, and hope you will enjoy the videos.